SafetyNet technology started because there's a big problem with overfishing in the commercial fishing sector. So fishermen are catching the wrong fish and they're really finding it difficult to target which fish they want to catch and leave the rest behind. About a fifth of the world's population relies on fish protein to survive. We basically catch that amount of fish that are thrown back and wasted every year. So they're kind of cancelling each other out. So for future food security, as the population grows, we need to make sure that the oceans can produce sustainable food. And that's what we're trying to do because the population is still growing. So for those people, it's incredibly important, but then there's jobs, there's also like ocean health and all sorts of things that we need to protect. The biggest problem that it looked like was happening was that fish were being caught in the wrong place in the first place. So then they get brought onto the boat, they die, they're thrown back and they're wasted. So the challenge was always, how do we stop catching the wrong fish at the bottom of the sea? And is that light, is it sound, is it geometry? And it turned out that light was a really good tool. So we've basically built devices that you can fit into fishing gear and they produce light. And that light can either attract fish to them or it can scare them away. And you can change the light to affect different species of fish and different organisms. So this is a Pisces, an old version of the Pisces unit that we built. So it's a light, basically it can be put into any fishing gear and it lights up, right? So let's say you're a cod and you like this kind of light, you're gonna swim towards it, right? But then if you set it up, so actually you find the light that the cod doesn't like, it's gonna swim away. So you can really set this up to be quite intelligent in terms of what you can and can't keep, or what you do or don't want to keep. And that allows fishermen to put logic into the fishing gear. So from the very beginning of this project, I've worked with fishermen and scientists and regulators to understand how what I was doing could benefit each of them, so that to massively raise the chance of it being accepted. So if everyone's happy about one part of the technology, then there's a much higher chance that they'll use it. And through doing that step-by-step process to show them the technology and ask them questions and ask for their feedback, there was a much higher sense of ownership from the people who were doing that, so the fishermen included. I think at the moment there's a big disparity between how people are affected by life, right? So if you look at places where people have access to food, access to water and money and education, there's an ability, they have a stable platform there to start building things, to become entrepreneurs, to have ideas, to have the space mentally to think about stuff. I think our thing is, if we can introduce food in a stable way to people, so we can protect that future food for everyone, then it adds more strength to that platform for other people to start thinking about other things rather than where their next meal comes from. So we can free up some mental space so people can start to have interesting ideas and do things where maybe they were too worried before.